Hey, I'm Erica.
And I'm Ashley.
And this is the Open Source Show.
Hi, I'm Ashley McNamara, developer advocate.
Hi, I'm Erica, and I do a lot of things.
What are you excited about in technology these days?
Oh man, I've been a nerd literally all my life. It's probably a problem. But right now I am very excited about and passionate about the application of technology to genealogy research. That's sort of where I live when I am not doing my actual job. My life goal personally is to like reassemble the family trees that slavery tore apart. And I feel like great open data sets and great algorithms put together with a little bit of like genetic genealogy can make great strides at making that happen.
Can you tell us a little bit more about what you found there? Like, what is open data, first of all?
Right. So quick way to describe open data is data that's just out there for anybody. So a large chunk of data about a specific topic that anybody can use for themselves. They can either query it online or download it to their computers. Census databases, data sets that include like insurance records. The open data that's out there about genealogy is just largely images. So it's technically open. Like, you can download any set of census records up to 1940 from the US government, for example. Even if you're looking at a small county, you're looking at like pages and pages and pages, right? And so it's open in the sense that anybody can download it, but it's not like open in the sense that it is useful for many people to like query and find out interesting things. And I love the idea of being able to completely open those data sets to make them queryable, such that we can find out interesting trends, find families that have maybe shifted around, just find useful data.
Can you tell me a little bit about why that started?
My grandfather died. And so I just was doing a family tree. And then I got more and more into it, and I was learning all these things about my family and like the people who went all over the place. And over time, it became like a really big passion for me, just because there are so many people of color in the US, specifically Black people who are descended from slaves, who don't have their family tree.
Right.
What's interesting for me is that up into around the early 1800s is when I hit a brick wall. And I want to go beyond the brick wall.
What are some tips that you would have for other people who are going through this as well?
Look at places that are unusual, right? Insurance records is a big one for people who are descended from slaves because they were property and so they were insured. Another thing I like to look at is data from small county courthouses. They have data going back to the early 1800s. And for my family specifically, there's a county that they came from in Virginia called Southampton County. And a person who has a lot of money went and was like, hey, I'm going to digitize all this data for Southampton County. And so wills are there. There are birth records, and you can find your ancestors there. Deeds. Court records are a big one, because when people go to court and they get sued and they have to like give up some of their property. The problem with that though is that a lot of these data sets from small county courthouses aren't digitized yet. They just exist in paper form. And this is like one of the things that keeps me up at night. One of my fears is that one of these county courthouses will get blown away in a hurricane and all that data will be gone. And I encourage anybody who is like maybe in a small town, a small county, go to the courthouse and just be like, hey, so can I just start taking pictures of your data sets and I'll just give them to you and then I'll put them online. That would be great.
And there are also some challenges, right, with open data sets.
Yeah, some things aren't queryable. And like I said about the census records, like it's just an image, not a lot you can do with just a picture. Oh, I can find out what the image name is. Not helpful. You can't find out useful information. So There's that challenge.
And as people are diving into open data, do you have any favorite data sets that you've looked into?
I really love the census data set. I feel like if it were queryable, it would illuminate so many different pieces of information that we just weren't able to see. Like, imagine being able to query the entire census for, let's say, the 1870 or 1880 census. And archive.org, the Internet Archive, for folks who don't know what that is basically it's an archive of everything, but they do a great job with open data sets. There are a lot of great open source tools for genealogy out there. I'm sure we can put some links around here somewhere. It's not just like a thing for your grandmother. There are a lot of innovations that could be made just using that data and trying to put together that puzzle.
I love it. Well, we learned a lot about open data.
Yeah, we did.
Thank you so much. We will provide some links. Yeah. And speaking of links, there's other links in here, but also subscribe and like and share and all of those other things. Follow us on Twitter, especially
Erica
at Ashley McNamara. Just so you know, we have a bunch of other open source goodness on opensource.microsoft.com.
It's down there somewhere.
Thank you for watching.